Good morning to all.
How are you, ma'am?
Yes, I'm fine, children. So let's begin today's session, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's begin today's session.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Can you see me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's begin today's session.
No, ma'am.
Yes, is it very clear, audible?
No, ma'am. No.
See.
We cannot see. We cannot see, ma'am.
Can you see?
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
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 I request, Sia, in today's session, as we are going to begin today's session, I request everyone to be ready with your rough book and your pencil. Only when it is asked to write, you're supposed to write. Otherwise, close your book, fold your hands, and sit properly for the class. Okay, the next thing I want you to do is, you all have to mute your microphones and switch on your videos. Okay, children, is that fine?
Okay.
Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
Let me start today's class.
Okay. Yes.
So, we focused on letters, words, and sentences. Okay, so we already know what are letters, what are words and sentences. In today's class, we are going to learn what is a sentence. Have you understood? What is a sentence? So we already know letters. We are familiar with the letters. We know that there are 26 letters in English alphabet. Okay, children? So, when we put the letters together, can you see me? Is it?
Yes.
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 When we put the... Okay. When we put the letters together, we get a word. Understood?
Yes.
When we put the letters together, we get a word. Okay, when we put the words together, we make a sentence. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Okay, now ma'am is going to share the screen with you. You don't do anything. Just fold your hands, look at the screen and see what is ma'am is doing. Only when you're asked to write, you write. Otherwise, you don't open your book. Is that clear to everyone? Okay, children, let's start. Yes.
I can see, ma'am. I can see, ma'am.
Okay.
I can see, ma'am.
Okay, all of you, look at the board.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Now, look at the sentence, what ma'am is going to write it on the board for you.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am is going to write a sentence for you. Yes, okay. Ma'am is going to write a sentence on the board. All of you look at the board. The
girl
is playing. I want all of you to fold your hands and sit straight and look at the screen. I don't want you to talk in between unnecessary. The girl is playing a piano. Have you noticed? The girl is playing a piano. Have you noticed this group of words? When group of words join together, we make a sentence. Have you? Okay, is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Group of words join together, make a sentence. Then we have already told that a sentence is a group of words that makes complete meaning. Understood? That makes complete meaning and that makes sense. Okay, complete sense. Now all of you read that sentence. The girl is playing a piano. Doesn't it make any sense, children? Okay, it tells us that the girl is playing the piano. Is that clear to everyone? Okay,
yes.
So the sentence tells us, it is a sentence, it gives us a complete meaning. Okay, so that is called a sentence. Have you all understood? It gives us a meaning, it makes sense, so it is a sentence. We'll say it once more. A sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Now, look at the sentence once more, all of you. The girl is playing a piano. Have you noticed? Now, have you noticed that the T, ma'am will write T, this is, I will write it again for you. The girl, all of you look at the screen, don't be looking here and there. The girl is playing. No unnecessary talking in between. The girl is playing a piano. Look at the screen, all of you. All of you fold your hands and sit. Okay. Now here, I could see you. The girl is playing a piano. We have already said when words join together, we get a sentence. A sentence is a group of words. It should make complete sense. Okay, that 2 points are very clear to us. Now, ma'am is going to ask you, have you not noticed the sentence here? The word T begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop.
Okay.
Note that the sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Have you noticed that?
Yes.
So in a sentence here, the word the begins with a capital letter as it is the beginning of the sentence. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Okay. The word the begins with a capital letter as it is the beginning of the sentence. Have you not seen that the word started with a capital letter T? Okay. Why it started with the T? Capital letter. It is the beginning of the sentence.
Sentence.
So started the sentence using a capital letter.
Letter.
And we ended the sentence using a
full stop.
You have to put a dot there. So we say that, or thus, we say that a sentence starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Is that clear to everyone? A sentence starts with a capital letter and ends with a
full stop.
Okay. Now all of you look at the screen. Okay.
Yes.
Key. No talking, children. All of you mute your microphones. He gave me. He gave the the book. He gave the book to Amit. Okay, A-M-I-T. And ma'am has put a full stop there. Look at the second sentence also. My uncle lives in Mumbai. Now all of you look at the first sentence. He gave the book to Amit. Here we have already told you, I've already told you that a sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Okay. Are you all listening? A sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. But have you noticed the word Amit? Amit is a name, is a special name of a person. Okay, he gave the book to Amit. Here, the word Amit starts with a capital letter as it is a special name of a person. Have you noticed that, children? The word Amit starts with a capital letter as it is a special name of a person. Okay, so Amit is the name of a person. So the word A should be written in capital letter. Now look at the second sentence. My uncle lives in Mumbai. So also we have started with a capital letter. No unnecessary talking. The children. Okay, my uncle lives in Mumbai. Here the sentence started with a capital letter. You can see here M in capital letter and ended with a full stop. But have you noticed the word M? M. Have you noticed the word M? Ma'am has written M in capital letter. Mumbai is a name of a place, is a special name of a place. So the word M should begin with a capital letter as it is a name of a place. Have you noticed that? Okay. The word Mumbai starts with a capital letter as it is a special name of a place. Okay, children. So two things we have seen here. Names of places and names of person must start with a capital letter. Have you all noticed that?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now we move on to the next thing. Okay. Now we are moving on. All of you look at this sentence on the board. How many cookies did you eat? All of you look at the sentence on the board. Don't write anything. All of you look at the sentence. Here you can notice that the sentence starts with a capital letter, but have you noticed the symbol at the end of the sentence? This symbol is called the question mark. Okay, so how many cookies did you eat? So the sentence asks a question. So the sentence should end with a question mark. Have you understood? A sentence when ask a question must end with a question mark. It has started with a capital letter and it should end with a question mark. Have you all understood that?
Yes.
So in today's class, we have noticed that a sentence makes sense. A sentence must start with a capital letter and end with a full stop. If special names of person and places must start with a capital letter. And a sentence ask a question, it should end with a question mark. Have you all understood that?
Yes.
Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
Is that clear to everyone? Yes. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Capital letter, starting with a capital letter, ending with a full stop. Special names of person and places has to be written in capital letter. In a sentence, asks a question. So end the sentence using a question mark, not a full stop. Have you all understood?
Yes.
Okay, all of you, be ready with your, just don't open your book, just look at the screen. Okay, children?
Okay.
Can you look at the screen? Can you see the screen?
Yes!
Yes.
All of you?
Yes!
Yes!
Yes.
All of you look at the screen. We have already seen that. The letters we are very much familiar with. All of you look at the screen. Hold your hands and sit. All of you. We are already familiar with all these letters. Now, I've already told you, when letters join together, we get a word. Have you understood? The group of letters form a word.
Words.
Okay. Can you look at the screen? When group of letters join together, we get a word. Can you see the word? The group of letters here make a word, dog. Here the group of letters join together, make a word, fox. Here the group of letters join together and we make a word, sun. Here the group of letters are joined together and we got a word. Have you all understood that?
Yes!
So, sentences. Letters, words, and sentences. So, here I've already told you, a sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sentence. Okay. Now, all of you look at the screen.
While writing.
Don't write anything, children. The notes will be sent to you through WhatsApp. I want all of you to look at the screen. Okay. So, while writing a sentence, I've already told you that, a sentence must start with a capital letter. And ends with a full stop. Have you noticed? See here, all of you, example, who's talking there? Can you hear, children? Can you hear me?
Yes.
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 So here, a sentence always starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Okay. The girl is crying. The girl
is always.
Okay. The girl is crying. Haven't you seen that the sentence starts with a capital letter T and ends with a
S?
Okay, is that clear to everyone? And look at the next sentence. My brother bakes cake. M, the capital letter, and ends with a full stop. Thus, we say that a sentence always starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes.
To the next. All of you look at this. This we have already seen. Okay. Okay. Names of person, place, animal, or thing begins with a capital
letter.
Look at this example. Akbar was a great king. Okay, Akbar is a name of a person. Okay, so it started with a capital letter and ended with a full stop. Rida, look here. My uncle lives in Mumbai. Have you understood? So M starts with a capital letter here and ends with a full stop. Mumbai is a special name of place, so it has to start with a capital letter. Have you noticed this? M is a name of a place. So the word Mumbai begins with a capital letter. Look at this sentence. She gave the book to Amit. Amit here, the word Amit starts with a capital letter since it is the name of a person. Have you all noticed?
Yes.
Okay. So let us move on to the next. So have you noticed that names of person, place, animal, or a thing to begin with a capital
letter.
Now look at this. All of you look at this. A sentence, when asked a question, has to end the sentence using a question mark. Okay. So here, look at the sentence examples. What color is the dog? So the sentence has started with a capital letter.
Brown.
What color is the dog? Starts with a capital letter W and ended in a question mark. Have you noticed the symbol there? The sentence has ended with a question mark. Have you noticed that, children? Will you play with me? Started with a capital letter.
Ended
with a question. Have you all understood? Let us move on to the next. Here, there is an activity for you to do, an exercise for you to do.
There are many books in the library.
All of you look at the screen.
First one is correct.
Okay, tick the ones that I've already told you.
There are many books.
Okay, you already know that a sentence makes sense. A sentence must start with a capital letter and must end with a full stop.
Okay.
Now let us do
it.
Tick the ones that are sentences and cross out that are not. Okay, now.
First one is correct.
Are you all ready?
Yes.
First
one. Can you unmute it and read the sentence for me? The first one.
Okay.
You have to tell me if it is a sentence. Read the following sentence and tell me which are the sentences. We are going to put a tick mark against the sentences and cross out the ones which are not. Okay. Prarthana, can you tell me, read the first sentence for me?
Yes.
Yes, read it.
There are many books in the library.
Okay, let me ask you. Is it a sentence, Prarthana? Is it a sentence?
Yes.
Yes. So it starts with a capital letter, you can see here, and end it with a full stop. And sentence makes sense. So what are we supposed to do? We have to put a
tick mark.
Okay, Abel Vargas, read the second sentence for me. Abel Vargas. Abel, will you read the second sentence for me? Unmute it and tell me, Abel.
Ben has a pet
dog. Yes, Ben has a pet dog. Abel. Ben has a pet dog. So you can see here in this sentence, it starts with a capital letter B and ended with a full stop. And it makes a sense. So Abel, is it a sentence? Yes, it, we should put a tick mark. Yes, it is a sentence. Tara, can you read the next one for me? Third one. Sarah?
And there.
And there. Is it a sentence, Sarah?
No.
No, it is not a sentence. It doesn't start with a capital letter, nor a full stop, and it doesn't make any sense. So we have to cross out. You all understood?
Yes.
Now, who can tell me the next one?
Ma'am. Ma'am.
Yes. Aramia, tell me the next one. Read it for me.
Jane
is my?
Jane is my.
Is my? Yes. Jane is my best friend. Okay. Jane is my best friend. Okay, let me ask Juvan. No, Aramia. Aramia, tell me the answer for me. Radia? Yes, is it a sentence? Is it a sentence, Aradhya? Yes or no? Read the sentence. Jane is my best friend. Yes, Jane starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop, and it makes sense. So is it a sentence?
Yeah.
Yes. So what should I do here? I should put the okay. Now, Juan, read the next one for me.
Ma'am, can I?
Juan, do the next one for me, Juan.
That is
sharp. Sharp. Is it a sentence, Juan?
No.
What should I do? Mitra.
Ma'am, can I?
Mitra. Read the next one for me. Mitra is there?
Yeah.
Okay, Farmers, can you read the next one for me?
Yes.
Farmers?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read it. Read the sentence for me.
Children,
the sentence for me. Playing children,
they are.
It started with a capital letter, ended with a full stop. But does it make a sense? Does it make a sense? Read the sentence once more.
Playing children are. And is the full
it doesn't
stop.
Make any sense. So it is not a sentence. So what we should do, we should put a cross against.
Cross.
All understood?
And can I now?
Okay.
Ma'am, can I?
Who can do it? Ridha, can you do the next one? Ridha?
Ma'am.
Yes, read the next sentence for me. Sixth sentence, sixth is over, seventh one. The apples, yes. The apples are?
Sweet.
The apples are?
Sweet.
Is it a sentence? Yes. It starts with a capital letter and ends with a full stop and it makes a sense. So what we should do?
Put a tick mark.
Yes.
Ma'am, can I?
Who's that? Read, can you tell me?
I know.
Sweet pick.
Read. Ma'am, can I?
Can I do the next one for me?
Yes.
Steve, can I do the next one for me? Apple, sweet, big. Apple, sweet, big. Is it a sentence, children?
No.
These are few words. It is not a sentence. So what we should do? We should
stop.
Cross mark.
Cross mark.
Okay. Put a cross mark. Have you all noticed it?
Yes.
Now you have to rewrite the following sentences using capital letters or a full stop. Okay, we are going to stop the class, but before that we'll do one exercise. Later the rest of the exercise we'll be doing it in the next class. Okay. We are going to the market. Here in this sentence, we have to start with a capital letter and we have to end with a full stop. So what we should do? W should be written in
full stop.
Yes, we
capital letter
are
going
to
the market.
Market. At the end of the sentence, what we should do?
Stop.
Now we have come to the end of today's session.
Knocking.
Okay, children. So we have come to the end of today's session. In the later session, we'll be learning how to write sentences using a capital letter and a full stop.
Yes. So,
bye. Okay, children. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.